The quest of hunting metamorphs for loot continues. If you have any hopes of leveling up, then let me show you a few quick clips. Greetings, Exiles, and welcome to Bare Minimum Episode 7, a video series where we take a look at low investment, low risk farming strategies. Following my previous episode, I decided to run another 100 of these in a different map and separate the loot of the map from the loot of the metamorph, so that we can have a good idea on how much we are able to make if we take most of the metamorph nodes on the tree. The map we ran was Tier 16 Cemetery, we chiseled and alked to around 80% quant, and we used two types of scarabs. 100 Rusted Metamorphs and 100 Rusted Divination Scarabs. Regarding the filter, we are using NeverSync 3.17 Uber Strict. Let's take a look at some loot. In this tab, called Meta, we have the loot that we managed to drop in 100 Metamorph fights ran in Tier 16 Cemeteries. We have some stack decks, we have some regals, quite a lot of chaoses, pretty much all of the generic currencies that you can find inside the game. We managed to find 3 jewels, these two are not worth a lot, this one is worth 25 chaos. Although these two are not worth much, they are some interesting drops, a prison guardian, an ivory tower. And also, for the other currencies, we have some fossils, as you can see here. We have quite a lot of scarabs and only one deafening essence. Now, deafening essences don't really drop from the metamorphs, but as you're fighting them, you can upgrade them into deafening. I do have a lot of other essences, if I'm not mistaken, they are in this tab here. These were also from the metamorphs, but seeing as how we couldn't really upgrade any of them into deafenings, I decided to only include this one in the metamorph loot tab. We have quite a lot of catalysts, pretty much all of the types of catalysts that you can find on the Uber Strict filter. And as you're looking at the screen right now, you may think that maybe it's a little bit too hard to sell all of these catalysts right here. But if we take a look at my previous selling session, well, this is pretty much what I was left with after the previous 100 metamorph runs. We managed to sell all of the catalysts except a few ones. There were a few messages that came after I finished my selling session, but I decided to continue on with running the maps and not fully liquidate this. So as you can see, we had a few similar tabs, kind of like these two, and we're only left with this. This is only around 1 hour of work at most to sell everything. So yeah, quite a lot of stuff. Regarding the organs, as you can see, we have 23 sets right here. However, you can take these extra organs and vendor them for other random organs. And you can probably make closer to 33-35 sets, which is what happened last time as I was running this experiment in the Tier 14 Burial Chambers. There's also gonna be a situation in which you'll end up around every, I'd say, 3 to 5 maps, which should appear on the screen right now. When you're in this situation, you can't really do anything about it. You're just gonna have to accept the fact that you only have one metamorph, and you shouldn't really be upset about it, because the loot that you get from the first metamorph is a lot greater than the loot that you get from the second metamorph. Besides that, if we were to take a total of this tab here without the organs, we have 1000 chaos according to Exilence. 1000 chaos in 100 maps means that on average a metamorph is giving us 10 chaos per map. Considering the fact that a rusted metamorph scarab right now is around half a chaos, you're making 9.5 chaos on average for each rusted metamorph scarab that you use. I would say that that is a pretty nice amount of loot to get for each fight at the end of the map, but you have to keep in mind that you need to run a build that is able to kill the metamorphs. They are a lot more tankier than the boss at the end of the map. Now let's move on to the tab called Loot 1. In this tab called the Loot 1, we have the other loot that we managed to drop inside the map. I think this shouldn't be in here. We have a lot of deafening essences, as you can see. We have a lot of scarabs, which we can vendor for other better ones. We have managed to find some Icarus and a few embers. I'm not sure how these are dropping because I'm not fighting Hachito. I'm only fighting Squidward. And we also have a lot of chaoses. We found some delirium mirrors, which give us a total of 89 simulacrum splinters. We have some alchemies, the generic currencies that you can find inside the game. We didn't actually drop any exalts. We did manage to drop, however, a few delirium orbs. But we did also manage to drop this empower support right here, which I'm sure it's quite expensive. Let's take a look. It's around 70 chaos. And we also managed to drop this dragon's heart here, which is another 50 chaos. So we have an X right here from these two big drops. As you can see, if we were to take a look at the invitations that we have here, we managed to drop in total 4 screaming invitations, and they are each around 60 chaos. We managed to drop the other invitations, but these I'm pretty sure don't really drop anything. We also have Twisted. We have quite a lot of the Elder maps. As you can see, in total there's 12 here. 4 of the Shaper maps and 4 of the Conqueror maps. You have to be careful with these, as Excellence is not including them into the total. And after mentioning this in my previous video as well, I forgot to add them at the end. So quite a lot of stuff. We have in total around 4000 chaos. Let's move on to the revenue, profits and the investment. And here are the numbers. In the left side of the screen you can see the revenue and the investment of the profits from the metamorphs, and in the right side of the screen would be the total as in the maps plus the metamorph. Regarding metamorphs, we have 1000 chaos in total or 7.4x, that would be the revenue. Our investment is 50c, because the metamorph scarab, a rusted one, is 0.5c. After we take out the investment, we are left with 950c or 7x in profit, and our profit per map, after running metamorphs with all of the nodes on the tree, except the ones that add the rogue metamorph, would be 9.5 chaos per map. Regarding the rest of the loot, as you can see in total, we have 4050 chaos, that is with the Conqueror maps added, I didn't forget to add them this time. Our revenue from organs is around 350c, our investment is 300 chaos, and our profit is 27.5x. Our profit per map is 37.5 chaos, and our profit with organs is around 30.3x. Our profit per hour in total with the organs included, that is if you were to sell all of your organs on TFT or Global 820, is around 3.6 exalts, and that is assuming 5 minutes per map, which is pretty much how fast or how slow I should say I complete them. Our total runtime is around 8.3 hours. Before we move on, I would like to mention the fact that as I was running Ashen Woods, I was only making 1 exalt per hour. And after I was running Metamorph Scarabs, I started making around 3x per hour. Now, looking at these numbers here, I really don't understand why I was making so little in those days. Maybe I got a little bit unlucky, but I did actually run Ashen Woods without a Metamorph Scarab for around probably 5 to 6 hours. So I think I just got terribly unlucky, it was an unlucky streak. If we take a look at the numbers as they are right now, we are making most of the profit from the map, and although the metamorph is adding some nice loot, you should definitely run it if you can, we're making 28 chaos from the map profit, and we're making another 9.5 chaos profit from the metamorph. Now, if you want to spec into metamorphs and add them, that is up to you if you think this is worth it or not. If you can probably insta-gib them, I think it's definitely worth it. Now, let's move on to the discarded loot, which would be the following. By discarded loot, I mean the loot that I didn't include into the total. We have a lot of maps, we have a lot of essences, we have a lot of contracts here, as you can see. We have these three blueprints, and we have more maps in here. With these 100 maps, I also wanted to try out the rusted cartography scarab and see if it's actually worth it to run it on your map. In the previous run, I actually made only 96 maps. However, in this run, I managed to make 153 maps. Now taking a look at the cartography scarab, you'll see that it says 20% more maps in the area. I was expecting to make around 120 maps. However, we actually made a lot more than that. We made 153 maps, and that would be not including the maps that you can see here. So we actually made quite a lot of maps. So considering the fact that these guys right here cost only 1 kios, you should definitely use them if you have any trouble with sustaining or maybe just wanna farm up more maps and sell them in bulk. Let's move on to the excellence now. And this would be our total in excellence. As you can see, there's the conqueror maps missing, so they are not added in this update of excellence. We have our total of all around 4000 kios. I decided to add the conqueror maps as 25 kios each. I will scroll through the loot slowly. If you feel the need, then pause the video and remove whatever you feel that shouldn't be in here. Let's do it by tabs, the loot 1 tab first. As for future plans, we are gonna take a small break from Metamorphs and we're gonna start testing some Blight Scarabs. I might return to Metamorphs, but after around 400 GPU melting boss fights, I'm gonna let my video card take a break and we're gonna do some blight farming. If you're interested in what we'll be able to make with 100 rusted blight scarabs, then stop by the channel. The video should be up either next Monday or Tuesday, depending on how much time I manage to play. My overall thoughts on metamorphs while using rusted metamorph scarabs are that they are pretty good for some currency if you have a build that has some decent single target. If you're running a clear speed build and you struggle a bit with the map boss, please don't try this. My build kills map bosses in around 3 seconds, but the metamorph fight can last up to even 30 seconds. Although that isn't always the case, and most metamorph fights usually end up in around 10 seconds, even if we were to go by those numbers, you are looking at a much harder fight than that of the map boss. If you don't know if your build can handle them, then metamorph scarabs are very cheap this league. Maybe buy a few, try it out, and see how it goes. Thank you for watching, good luck as always, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys!